to be somewhere on an island. You know what I mean? But for real though.
Take this overboard. I feel that heat, and we can ride the boogie. Share that heat of love.
Good morning and welcome to a new vlog. Today is Wednesday, May 25th, of course, 2023. I'm up. I'm about to do a couple of things in the kitchen before I head out. I'm going to get this head braided. That's why I got this baseball cap on this morning. But before I go any further, let me just introduce myself to my new viewers. My name is Kinshasha Rhodes, aka Sweet Shashwan. And on this page, we'll just pretty much, I want to say, well-rounded. This is a lifestyle page. We talk about everything from food to finance, relationship, shopping, DIYs, home improvements, home updates, you name it, we talk about it. There's just nothing off the table. So welcome. And to all my other subscribers that's always here tuning in every week, thank you, love you for free. So I'm up. I'm about to make some iced coffee, some ice rather, for my iced coffee. I showed you guys these silicone ice cubes holder thingies like a few vlogs ago. Ice cube molds, how about that, a few vlogs ago, and finally I'm getting a chance to actually use them. They are in the shape of a coffee bean. I have two here and here. I will leave these link in the description box for you guys if you are interested in having some of these. To me personally, I am an iced coffee drinker. It is like iced coffee season for me. Even though it's still chilly here, it's May and it still feels like October, but nevertheless I still like my iced coffee this time of the year. So me personally, I feel like when you put ice in iced coffee, that the water dilutes the coffee. So I use like a decaf coffee, and I freeze the coffee and use those in my iced coffee for ice cubes to keep the coffee cool. And when the ice melts, it is actually coffee instead of water, okay? And also, now, I haven't done it before, but I am actually going to flavor my iced coffee. So I have, you know, some of these. I use, you know, any sugar-free. It's up to you what you want to use. You don't even have to use decaf coffee. If you want to, you can use regular coffee, a flavored coffee, whatever floats your boat. This is just my preferences. So I'm going to use a decaf coffee that I made already. I'm going to use one of my many flavors that I have here to actually flavor my coffee cubes. And I'm also going to make some protein shake ice cubes as well in these trays, just because sometimes I have my protein shakes aren't always in the fridge, because sometimes there's just no space in there. So once again, just like the coffee, when you add the ice to it and it melts, it makes the protein shake taste disgusting. So instead of melting with water, I'll melt it with more protein shake, okay? That's something I do, you know what I mean? It's up to you. I'm just here to give you the tea. It's up to you what you do with it. So I'm gonna get this done. I'm gonna flavor.
I got holes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas cross the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps were the facts, so they sat with the bars. I got two phones, one need a charge. Yeah, they twins, I could tell they ass apart. I got big packs coming on the way. I got big stacks coming out to save. I got Lil Max with me, he the wave. It's a big gap between us and the game. In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid. When I die, I put my money in a grave. When I die, I put my money in a grave. I really gotta put a couple niggas in a place. Really just slap every nigga in a race. I really might tap, kill this nigga on my face. Lil CC, let it slap with the bass. I used to save hoes with a mask and a cape. Now I'm like, nah, love, I'm good, go away. Ain't about to die with no money I done gave. I was on top when that shit meant a lot. Still on top, like I'm scared of the drop. Still on top, and these niggas wanna swap. Niggas wanna swap like it's sauce in a box. I don't wanna change, cause I'm good where I'm at. Mile tie, so I'm always good where I'm at. Word of Junior, Jazzy, Baby J. Tell them when I die, put my money in a
couple frickin' killer scars and collect. She fuck a nigga, then she on to the next. Really living large, she ain't all with a Mac. Little niggas think it's small in the mall with a rat. Roll with us if you really wanna get it. Go get a hit for me and you just run it.
Hey y'all, what's up? I'm in the car. I'm halfway down to Harlem. I am going to get my hair braided. You know, about a week or so ago, I took my braids out. And, you know, I get a little, I don't know why this camera is looking so blurry. I don't know if it's the car, the lighting, or what it is, but everything looks blurry. I hope you guys can see me clearly. But from what I'm seeing, it looks really, really bad. So I took my braids out about a week and a half ago, almost 2 weeks. So I'm putting them back in because I'm not ready to cut my hair as of yet. And I know if I get to the point of frustration, I'll go and get it cut. And I want it to grow out just to get a little fuller on top. I'm still gonna keep the pixie cut, but I want my bangs to be a little longer, if possible. You know, I'm not guaranteed to that's gonna happen, but I'm gonna try. So I'm gonna do another round of braids. I'll see how those look when that's done and decide whether I want to continue with the braids or go ahead and get a cut for the summer. And I'm hoping that this is not gonna take like too long. I'm literally getting there on time this morning. I mean, the traffic is a bitch per usual, but I'm still getting there on time, like literally right on time. No matter how early, how late you leave, it's just always some nonsense. Hold on, y'all. I'm just trying to cross over because I'm about to miss my exit. The effers. Sorry about that. So, what was I saying? Oh yeah, I'm praying that it doesn't take too long. I want to make one other stop before I head home to H-Mark. I want to go and get a pink pineapple so I can share with you guys. So we'll see, depending on how traffic is and how long this take, will determine whether this is gonna be a spend the day vlog with me or I'm gonna continue it to the next day. So I don't know, but I'm gonna get off this camera so I can focus and get to my destination safely. So I'll see you guys once I'm in the salon. She's making them too tiny, so this is definitely gonna take longer than usual. But it's okay. As long as it's pretty. But I'm in love with it already. We haven't even put any water or product in it.
Can you shake it? Turn around and shake your hair. Oh my God.
I'm back. My hair is done. As you can see, it's dark now. So we're talking about 8 hours later, maybe 9. Yeah, about 8 because we did stop once because she had to eat something. I had to just run to the store to grab something. I ate bad today because I'm on the street. So, whatever. The day is done. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to make it to the place to go pick up my pink pineapple. So, I'm going to continue this vlog until tomorrow. Maybe I'll chit chat and pick up the camera and talk to you guys once I get home. And, of course, I'm going to show you my hair. I love it. It's so beautiful, but it took so long because she did it super small and long, and that's something we usually don't do. I usually do it pretty long, but not this small. So anyways, I ain't gonna ramble. I will show you guys later. made it home finally. I'm going upstairs now. I will chit chat with you guys tomorrow. We'll get into the details of this hair. I'll let you know everything that I used and give you her information too as well. And I'll leave a video in this video so you can see the hair, or I'll just show it to you tomorrow, one or the other. But I'm tired, I'm hungry, and I'm going to end the day here. I did check in with the place that sold the pink pineapples. They are currently sold out now, so we'll do that on another day. But I do have some things that I want to share with you tomorrow, so we'll get into that. Until then, y'all have a good night. Morning, sweetie gang. Happy Thursday. Today is May 25th, of course, 2023. I'm up this morning. Got a few things I need to do, make a few moves. In the kitchen, I'm going to make my iced coffee. Remember yesterday I showed you where I was freezing my protein shakes and my coffee in the molars for ice instead of using water. But before I get into that, let me just give you a look at my hair. Here it goes. See if I can get a little closer. I'll insert a video for you guys. Also, I'll leave the information to the person that did it if you're in the New York area, and I'll tell you exactly the hair that I use on my hair. Okay, so I'll leave those details for you as well. And I also located my pink pineapples, so I am going to go and pick those up. I'm gonna take you guys along with me and put those bad boys maybe in the fridge so they could cool off. Hopefully they are in the freezer section at the supermarket, so they're already cold. We'll bust them open and try them together. And I have a couple of new pieces I want to share with you. What else? Oh, I got some shoe hacks for you as well, for you ladies that have problems with wearing heels. I got a couple of gems that's gonna make them a little bit more comfortable for you. All right, so we're gonna get into that today, and that'll be it. So let me get my molds. So here we go. It smells so good. This is the coffee. Here's the protein. Of course, here's my coffee. These are my glass, my glass cups that comes with the bamboo lids and the glass straws. I've showed you guys these glasses like, I don't know how many vlogs ago, like last year. Like when I first started vlogging, I showed you these glasses. But for those of you that hasn't watched my new people, that hasn't watched some of my older vlogs, I'll leave this information in the description box, or go over and do your girl a favor and just watch the vlog. How about that? And here are glass straws too. They come in two shapes. They come in the straight, in the curve, and it comes in the straight, and then they give you the little little bristle thingies to actually clean the straws. The pipe cleaners is what it's called, I think. And this set comes in like a set of four. Okay, so yeah. And got me some more creamer. Zero sugar, of course. So I'm gonna add little this, little that. As a matter of fact, we're gonna froth this, okay? How about that? And I have a frother. I'll link that below in the description box for you guys as well. Okay. So let's get into this coffee.
outfit of the day. I have on this navy blue jumper. I have like some print on it. I love bumpers. And I have on some white uptown sneakers. Of course, I don't know if you can see it in here, but I have two gold anklets on, Apple Watch, and bracelets made by me. And of course, the new do. And that's it. I'm going to pair it with probably a denim jacket and my denim YSL bag. So, here we go. I'm back. Before I bust out our pink pineapple, because I did get it for us today. Sorry I didn't take you guys along. There's just a lot of moving parts today, so I really didn't have my camera, and then the battery died. But anywho, before I share the pineapple with you guys, I got a couple of little finds that I want to share with you. First, let's start with this. So if you haven't been living under a rock, or you are a hair girl like me, I'm sure you guys have seen these. I have a few pair in the black. So these are the shoe gummies, right? So these are the red ones. She recently started selling these in the red bottoms last year. And I have a few pair that I want to apply these to. Now, these are for the Louboutins, and hold on, so I do have them in the black and a few other shoes. These here are YSLs. I cannot wear these or these Tom Fords. Was killer, okay? These gummy soles made all the difference. You see, it gives you a little platform under the shoe, and it's not noticeable while you're wearing the shoe. It doesn't take anything from your shoe, but it gives you a small platform, as you can see, and it makes the shoe more comfortable. You can actually stay on it a little longer. These two here, I absolutely cannot wear at all. These here were fine. I wasn't able to stay in them for a long period of time. Now I can wear them for hours on end. I could dance the night away in these now, and in these, because they were so, you see, it's so flat, but this gave it a platform in order for it to work, to make it more comfortable. So hold on. Now these are a new pair of Nudes that I have. They are like the 100 millimeters, not the 120s, but still, the other red bottoms that I have, they are all 85. Don't even go there, because the heel is high enough, but it's comfortable. So I didn't need them for other ones, but these in particular, I did. I think I wore these once, and it was a wrap. I was just like, never again. And then when she came out with the red soles, I was like, okay, now I can get some wear out of these. I had these for years and wore them literally one time. But let's look at that heel. Look, you see this? What are they doing at? Nope. No thank you. No ham, no ma'am. Get somebody else to do it. So I'm hoping that I get the same results from these two pair that I got from the other shoes that I wasn't able to wear until I put those gummy soles on. I'm telling you guys, for one pair, they are pricey, but if you are wearing high-end expensive shoes, $30-$50 ain't gonna kill you to enjoy a pair of $1,000 shoes, okay? To just let them sit in your closet is nonsense. So get something that's gonna make that shoe comfortable for you, where you can enjoy it and be able to wear it for the full event or party or whatever the case may be. So get you some of these. I have another pair of shoes that's not like expensive. They're actually like a Steve Madden. This here is not comfortable. But she has the gummy in like a yellow color, like a creamy color. So I think I'm going to buy that color for these. If not, I might just throw the black on. I'm not sure. But she does have something that's like in a nude color for a shoe that has like a nude bottom. So she has it in a nude color. She has it in red. And she has it in black. So do yourself a favor and go and get it. I will leave her website or something down in the description box if you guys want to check it out for yourself. She does take, I think, Afterpay. So that's another option if you have to buy a few of them and you don't want to buy, you know, one set for $50. If it's for the red bottoms, I think it's $50. I think for the black and the new color, I think they're $35, okay? But you can check me on that. So I'm just, you know, just letting you guys know. Like I always tell you, I'm just here to bring you the tea. It's up to you what you do with it. So I am going to apply these on these and these for the next time I wear them. Then I found another little gem on Amazon, of course. Let's see if I can open it. I don't know where my scissors are. Let me see. So I got these little babies here, right? And they are claw stompers. So if you're having an event that's outside, or if you're walking on these dangerous sidewalks in New York City or other places, these are stompers, because I have damaged so many of my shoes because they have gotten stuck in like the creaks and the cracks in the sidewalks. So these are supposed, and I haven't used these yet, so I can't verify for you. I'm just sharing with you, but once I wear them, I will let you know. So this summer, if you're out and you're at an event, say if it's in the grass and you have on heels, this here supposed to help you from sinking in the grass. Or if you just want to have them on just to not rip your heel, or like I've done it several times on my shoes. So here it is. And it's called Stompers. This is one company that I found first. They do have some other companies that have them that are a little cheaper. These, I think, for one set was like $11. I saw another company that gave you like five or so for like $13, but the reviews weren't as great. So, you know, tread lightly and read the reviews and make your own decision. If not, you know, you can always send things back to Amazon. But these are supposed to support you if you're like at an outside event or maybe a wedding that's outside and you have on heels and your heels won't sink into the dirt. You know how that goes. So these are something that can save your shoes, save your heels. And these are things, let me show you another. I have a black set that I haven't used yet. Hold on. Here's another set in black, see? That can save your feet and your shoes. So, this is in the black here. And this is in the red. And you got a few shapes depending on your shoe. So, for this here is for my pointed toe. So, it literally just goes here. She gives you a file. It's instructions that come with it. In the box, there's a file. I'm not filing my shoes. I never did with any of them. You're supposed to file it, I guess, to get a grip on it, and then take a rag, clean that off, and then take it and put it on the shoe. I'm telling you, this is a game changer. It works. Okay? So, yeah. You put them on the shoe, and that's the shape is for this, for pointy toe, and it's a more round shoe. You can use this shape, and it just, I have to take this other grip off, but it kind of goes, oh, this is a wrong one. Yeah, here we go. And it goes here. You just place it, and depending on your shoe size, so they do come in small, medium, and large. This is a small, and you just kind of place it, hover it over the shoe, like I said, and bang, and you can use a blow dryer to like heat it and make sure the adhesive sticks. So those are my shoe savers for you. Let me show you a couple of things that I picked up from Zara this week too. I'll be right back. For example, this is a I want to show you of where what I mean by your heels getting damaged. You see, if they get stuck in the concrete or in the cracks, they'd get damaged. And this is quote unquote been fixed. I probably damaged it again, but you see, I'm gonna have to take it back to the shoemaker to have him fix that. But I just want you guys to see what I mean, and I guess that stomper will stop it from going into the concrete. So get you some, okay? Get you some. Okay, so now Zara, I keep telling you guys I'm gonna stay out of this. I think this is my last one for a while. I purchased these pink pants. I'm gonna turn it inside out. Let me show you. They're super cute. Have the super big pockets in the back, and then they have the buttons down here. Pockets on the side. Let me try them on real quick for you. Hold on. Okay, so here we go. It's like a little ankle pants. I love the detail of the button down to the bottom. Here are the pockets, and they have these extra large pockets in the back. Per usual, you know, I have the waist gappage. I have to show you guys how to fix this, or you can go and check out the vlog that has this in it. But I'm gonna fix this where it works here, okay? But yep, these are it. They're super cute. I will style these for you guys soon. I need to be somewhere where I am can wear my new items, because the weather is not breaking here. It's staying chilly. I feel like I have to fly out just to be able to wear my items. But these are it. And you know, you can style them by your choice. You can use a flat, a sneaker, a heel. You could dress these pants up, or you could dress them down. It's totally up to you. But yes, that's one item. And I do have one thing to show you, not only from Zara's, but something from one more item from Amazon. I'll be right back. Cute little number from Zara's. I bought this dress in a medium, but for the boobage, I think I'm gonna have to take it back and get the large, because these boobs aren't gonna let me be great. I'll figure out the rest of the body, take it in or whatever, because it's gonna be a little big. But this is a dress, to me, is so classy, so sexy. I love it. You know, I got vacation summer on my mind, and these braids don't help at all, because I need to be somewhere on an island, you know what I mean? But for real though, this dress right here is super cute, super sexy. Like I said, this is a size medium, but the boobs area, I don't know if it's gonna work out, so I think I'm gonna have to take them back and get the large, just because of these tatas. And I'm gonna pair them. These are a pair of Zara sandals too. I'm gonna pair them with this, I'm thinking. I don't know, I didn't try it on yet, but this is just where my mind was. What you think? Yeah, I got these army fatigue shorts. My stomach right now is so bloated, I'm like a freaking balloon, but I digress. So yeah, so everything right now feels like Loompa Loompa, because I'm bloated like crazy. But these are the fatigue shorts that I found on Amazon, which have been super hard for me to find some that I actually like. It has an unfinished bottom here, but I'm sure, because I'm so short, that I'm going to cuff that. And they do run small, like it says it up there under the description, run small, so definitely go up a size. But yeah, these are it. Once again, you know, I got the gapish problem, but I think they're super cute. So I will also leave these in the description box for those that may be looking for some nice fatigue shorts or something for the summer. Okay, but yeah, this is it. So I'm gonna change. Here is our pink pineapple. Comes in a nice pretty box. It says the wild jewels of the jungle. Oh, let me see if you can see it. All right, so we're gonna cut her open and see what she tastes like. All right. Okay. So, for starters, she doesn't have the sprouts or whatever leaves like the normal pineapple, as you can see here clearly on the box. Right? Okay. Nice and soft. I just need to get a photo. Hold on, I'll be right back. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. It's like a pink Starburst. It's good. Way better than the regular. It reminds me of a pink Starburst, all jokes aside. Whoa. It's sweet and sour, just like a pink Starburst. So if you love pink Starburst, you gonna love this. Yeah, it's hitting for something. Whew. This thing is yummy. Nice and juicy. I know I'm looking and sounding mad greedy, right? It's just that good. It's as good as it looks. And it tastes as good as it smells. Try to find one in your area and try it for yourself. Okay, so with that being said, this comes to the end of this vlog. Thanks for rocking out with me. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will tune in with you guys over the weekend. Make sure you have a safe Memorial Day weekend. Don't get into too much. Don't drink and drive and all that good stuff. But enjoy the weekend. And whatever I do, you know you guys are coming along. And I will see you in the next vlog. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Be good. Take this overboard. I want you to feel that heat. And we can ride the boogie. Share that feeling of love. I want to ride.